Columbus State is all about community. It's in our name. Not just one community, but it's a very diverse community. We have students that come from across the state, across the country, and it's our home.
Columbus State was really the only school that I could think of that would accept me. Before, I didn't take school seriously, so I didn't have the best grades, and my experience here has been a complete 180.
Through Columbus State and through my relationships with people here, I was actually able to find my direction and purpose for what I wanted to do for my life and the rest of my career.
I know before I came here, I didn't utilize a lot of the skills that I have. Now I am, because of the network and opportunities that were given to me here. So Columbus State has really impacted me personally.
My vision for my future has just been solidified through going here. I've met more people and networked with more people than I ever could have before.
I did grow mentally, socially, intellectually in ways that I didn't think possible at Columbus State.
Not only am I a mom and raising three children, but I'm also a recovering addict who has almost 5 years sober. I'm the first one in my family to graduate from college, and I'm very proud of myself.
Overall, it's been a great experience, and I'm so excited to see what this degree is going to lead me to and where the connections that I made through it are going to take me.
I spent 3 years and worked hard to get to what I wanted to do with my life. It means a lot to know that Columbus State helped me get to where I need to be.
It's really exciting to be here this moment. It's been a long journey, but I know finally we made it.
Welcome to the Columbus State Community College 2020 Commencement Ceremony. This is a great day of celebration for our graduates, their families, and their friends. Commencement's always my favorite day. The opportunity to join you and your families to celebrate this life-changing accomplishment is one of the reasons I love my job. Congratulations to each of you. We hate to see you go, but we love to see you reach this milestone. The graduates we recognize today are distinguished in so many ways. And given what you've collectively experienced and overcome, it seems appropriate that we recognize you in a commencement ceremony that is notable and unique in several ways. First, this is a landmark moment for Columbus State. This is the 200th commencement ceremony in the college's history. It's also our first ever virtual graduation. That's clearly not our preference. A typical commencement at Columbus State is a joyful, collective celebration of everything that makes our community special. But virtual delivery and online education have been a strength of the college for years. In 2020, we've built on that strength, and our team has worked hard to make this virtual celebration special and joyful in a different way. This is also the first time that we honor graduates for an entire year in a single commencement. We typically have a ceremony in May to recognize spring graduates and another in December to recognize those graduating in the summer and fall. Today, we recognize all of the graduates of 2020, a cohort whose members share a pretty special bond. To cross the finish line of 2020, juggling school, family, and work, as our students so often do, and to do so while grappling with challenges our society hasn't confronted in more than a century, is truly remarkable and deserving of celebration. Columbus State is the front door to the American dream. For more than half a century, students have started or restarted their lives with a degree from Columbus State. And now this graduating class continues that tradition with over 2,800 graduates joining the ranks of Columbus State alumni. Columbus State is by far the most diverse institution in our region, and each of our graduates has a unique story. Yours are transformative stories of hope and perseverance. Many of you have balanced one or more jobs, family responsibilities, and other competing priorities with your academic workload. You've shown determination, courage, talent, and a work ethic that will serve you well wherever you go. We're happy to share some of those stories with you today. 2020 has been a tremendously challenging year, And that makes this recognition of you and your accomplishments that much more powerful. We're incredibly proud today to confer degrees upon each of you. And we're happy and grateful that you've joined us for this incredible occasion. It's with great pleasure now that I introduce the chair of the Columbus State Community College Board of Trustees, Mr. Anthony Joseph. Anthony is Chief Administrative Officer, General Counsel, and Secretary of the White Castle Management Company. And he will introduce today's commencement speaker.
Kurt Walker is Chief Executive Officer of Nationwide, a mutual insurance and financial services company focused on protecting people, businesses, and futures with extraordinary care. He was elected to this position in 2019, and in this role also serves as a member of the Nationwide Board of Directors. Kurt initially joined the Nationwide family of companies in 1986. During his first 23 years at Nationwide, Kurt served in various leadership positions. Prior to being elected CEO, he served for 10 years as President and Chief Operating Officer of Nationwide Financial. In 2013, Governor John Kasich appointed Kurt to Columbus State's Board of Trustees. During his six-year term as trustee, Kurt was instrumental in successful efforts to raise funding for Mitchell Hall, the new home to the college's top-ranked hospitality programs, and in the successful introduction and passing of Issue 21, which will result in great gains for our students and our community. Kurt's leadership philosophy focuses on the four P's: people, planning, performance, and partnerships. This philosophy extends to driving an engaged, caring culture of associates that leads to better solutions for customers and other stakeholders. I've personally experienced and benefited from Kurt's authentic and well-developed leadership skills as he served as a board member at my company and was instrumental in connecting me with President Harrison and Columbus State 4 years ago. Kurt is a graduate of Iowa State University, where he earned a Bachelor of Arts degree in management. He also holds a Master of Science in Management with an emphasis in leadership degree from the American College. A native of Irvington, Iowa, Kurt was raised on a century farm, instilling the values of hard work and community responsibility that he carries forth today. It is my great pleasure to introduce our featured speaker, Kurt Walker.
Anthony, thank you for that introduction, and President Harrison, special thanks for the invitation to be part of today's ceremony. It's an honor to celebrate this important milestone with the Columbus State community. To the Columbus State grads, hey, congratulations. You've reached the end of your program, and what a journey it has been. And how interesting to be in college during this time in our history. Earning a degree is a significant accomplishment. Earning a degree during a global pandemic and a year marked by social unrest, economic and job market challenges, and a contentious political season is nothing short of remarkable. Wow. So I'm excited to be with you today. You see, 13,727 days ago, I was in your seat as a fresh graduate of higher learning. Like you, I'm a proud product of the junior college system, Ellsworth Community College in Iowa Falls, Iowa. Many of you may be thinking, well, this is the end. I would offer that it's the end of the beginning. Whether you're entering or continuing in the workforce, taking the next step towards a four-year degree, or maybe even starting your own business, I can assure you that your journey is just getting started, and I'm confident that you're ready for the ride. And if there's one thing we've learned in 2020, it's that the future got here faster than anticipated. Being in COVID lockdown and navigating economic uncertainty have accelerated changes in the way we think and behave as consumers. It's also accelerated change in the way businesses operate, including the companies many of you will go on to join. Some would say that we've covered a decade in mere days. Here are a few examples. Disney Plus achieved in 5 months what it took Netflix 7 years to build, 50 million subscribers. I'll bet many of you who needed to see a doctor in the last few months have done it virtually. Recent studies say the use of telemedicine recently increased tenfold over just 15 days. From March to June, e-commerce grew almost 32%. The pandemic accelerated the shift away from physical stores to digital shopping by 5 years. The future we thought might be coming is already here. And what this means is companies and the world aren't slowing down, and you can't either. My advice? Be a lifelong learner. People often ask me how I stay on top of, and even ahead of, this rapid change. The answer is I read, and I seek out the people who know more about what I want to know. I love to read. See, I grew up in a small town in Iowa in a family with limited means. Every summer, I joined the summer reading club at the library. It was my ticket to travel the world and expand my horizons. If reading books isn't for you, try podcasts, audiobooks, TED Talks, museums, magazines. There are lots of ways to feed your brain. And it has never been so easy to connect to the people at the leading edge of what you want to know more about. Pick out 10 people who are the leading voices in the things you want to know. Follow them on your favorite social platform and study what they have to offer. As I look back, one thing that's been productive for me is following the four P's: people, planning, performance, and partnerships. The four P's are my leadership philosophy. Together, they form a model that guides my actions and my decisions. What's great is you can apply the four P's to both personal and to business life. The four P's start with people. What my parents said is true. Surround yourself with excellence. When you work and play with people better than you, you up your game and you help others to up their games. Find quality people to be on your team. And when you're a manager, hire people who are smarter and better than you. You might feel threatened in that moment, but I'll guarantee you'll be more successful as a result. The second P is planning. Planning tells you where to focus your time, energy, and resources. So what's next for you? I want to encourage you to clearly decide what that is. What are your goals? I like to say what gets measured gets done. So when you figure out what you want to accomplish, what you want to be, share that with other people. There's magic in declaring to others how you'll get there. It engages them in helping you and holding you accountable for achieving your goals. Years back, I applied for a job. I was sure the job was mine. At the office, I was the first to arrive and the last to leave. I put in more hours than any other candidate. In my own mind, I was the best choice. Guess what happened? I didn't get the job. I went home feeling angry and confused. My wife Cindy encouraged me to talk with the hiring manager. I did, and I learned a valuable lesson from that experience. It's not always about working hard. It's also about working smart. The hiring manager encouraged me to have a career plan. I'd been so caught up in the idea of outworking the person next to me that I failed to focus on the bigger picture. And that's when I realized that work ethic could only take me so far, and I developed a long-term plan that helped guide my career. Next comes performance, the third P. Performance is about putting your plan into action. Focus on doing things well, honestly measuring your plan, sharing your progress, and adjusting to ensure future success. I actually hung my career plan on the fridge with magnets. My whole family could see it and follow along. My daughters would say, "Dad, I see your yellow or red over here. What are we going to do about it?" We all need people in our lives who will hold us accountable. Who are these people for you? One thing that's worked for me is having a personal board of directors, people you trust that you can go to for advice. And here's what's important. Look for people who care enough about you to give you honest feedback, not people who are only going to tell you what you want to hear. So we've covered people, planning, and performance. The fourth P is partnerships. At Nationwide, we know our success depends on our ability to work together as one team. All competition should be outside our walls. As you interact with others, your family, your friends, your work colleagues, spend some time deepening those relationships. And don't forget about community partnerships. Go out and find something you're passionate about. Making a difference can bring meaning and purpose to your life's work. Two organizations that I volunteer with are the American Red Cross and the Mid-Ohio Food Collective. The Red Cross, because in 1979, an F4 tornado struck my hometown. The Red Cross volunteers were among the first on the scene, offering comfort and relief to those in need. My work with the Mid-Ohio Food Collective stems from growing up on a family farm, land that has been in my family for more than 100 years. Farmers work to create a stable and abundant food supply for society. What keeps me up at night is knowing that more than 54 million people will experience food insecurity this year. In Ohio, 1 in 8 kids will go to bed hungry. I want to do something about that. We all have gifts to give. How will you use yours? One final thought: someone, somewhere along the way, took a chance on you and on your education. One person, in some way, helped you to get where you are. Reach out to that person and let them know that they made an impact. A call, a letter, a text, just say thank you. And I would encourage you to continue thanking people your entire life. People may not remember what you say, but they will remember how you make them feel. An attitude of gratitude will get you far. Columbus State grads, today is the end of the beginning. Today is your opportunity to commit to success. Henry Ford once said, "Whether you think you can or think you can't, you're right." I think you can, and I hope you believe it too. Be a lifelong learner. Follow the 4 P's: people, planning, performance, and partnerships, and have an attitude of gratitude. Without a doubt, your future will be bright. You got this.
Each of the graduates we celebrate today has a unique story. For most of you, student has been just one of many important, sometimes competing roles you've played. Your parents, your caregivers, your employees. And this year, many of you have added new roles like homeschool teacher, tech support expert, and curbside shopper, among others. You have busy lives, and your stories are compelling. No one knows and understands our students and their stories better than our faculty. That's in part because many of our faculty also understand busy lives. But what makes Columbus State faculty special is their shared passion for working with students. They've chosen to pour their scholarship into each of you. And over the course of teaching, mentoring, assuring, advocating, coaching, and cheerleading, they've come to understand our students and their stories as few others can. And so here are 4 stories of 4 remarkable 2020 graduates told by proud faculty members who have made your success their life's work.
Today is a day in which we acknowledge, admire, and affirm the graduates of Columbus State Community College. In the summer of 2018, I was teaching a class, a business management class, in Delaware Hall. And after the class, one of the students came up to me and said, "Professor B, may I speak with you for a moment?" "Sure." And she began to tell me her story. You see, she had started school some years ago and was unsuccessful at college. As she was coming back and she was under the forgiveness program, but she had some uncertainty, she had some doubts. She didn't know if she could make it, she didn't know if she could graduate, but she wanted to make a difference. She wanted her life to have meaning and she wanted to pursue her objectives and her goals, but with tears rolling down her eyes, she said, "I don't know if I can do this." That was the summer of 2018. In 2019, she was inducted into Kappa Beta Delta. She was also inducted into the National Society of Student Leadership. She was selected to study abroad and travel to Germany for 11 days. She became a certified tourism ambassador for the city of Columbus and received the keys to the city to deliver to Dresden, Saxony, Germany. She joined the Women's Connection and was awarded a scholarship. Through a program with Columbus Public Schools, she became a mentor and began working with at-risk students at Northland High School, her alma mater. Amber Battle, today we admire your growth. We acknowledge your perseverance. We affirm that you are in fact making a difference, and we applaud your graduation. Amber Battle, it doesn't matter where you start. It matters where you finish. Congratulations.
That's so sweet. Oh my goodness. That is so sweet. I just would like to say thank you so much. Thank you, thank you, thank you is an understatement. For Professor Barksdale, yes, he was the first professor that I met, and I didn't know what to do. I didn't know what to do, but he apparently saw something in me that I didn't see in myself. And, you know, he gave me that drive, that motivation, and he truly, truly inspired me. Professor Barksdale, Terry Stolte, she believed in me. Little lady, she believed in me so much. She nominated me, actually, to go to Dresden, Germany, and without her seeing and believing something in me that I didn't even see, I would have never had that opportunity. To all of the business program faculty, they have all been amazing. They've all been amazing. I'm so, so thankful to my family for expecting so much out of me and causing me to like push me to that limit. To my daughter who is in heaven, I made a promise to her that I would complete this journey. So even more than starting the journey, I would complete this journey. And I just want to let her know, if she's watching over me, that this chapter is done. This chapter is done. We've made it. Without, you know, God's grace and God's mercy and his comfort and protection, I would not be here today. So I would just like to take this time to encourage somebody. I could not see this a year ago. And so I had to shake myself and look beyond what my trials were, what my tribulations were. And so I knew that if I could see past all of the obstacles, I was halfway there. So to encourage someone who may feel like giving up, this is a very, very hard time. This is a very trying time. Don't give up, because if you can see that light, you're almost there. Thank you, Columbus State, for all of the opportunities that I've been afforded.
When you're performing theater for an English-speaking audience and English is your first language, it's easy to take for granted your ability to understand the words, articulate the words, project the words. Now imagine English being your second language and wanting to perform for an English-speaking audience. That was the challenge that Alex was faced with, and he did it admirably. He came to Columbus State as an English second language student and then became a theater major. And for the last 2 years, I've had the pleasure of working with him in several of our theater courses. He's taken acting class, advanced acting, script analysis, and he's also performed in 3 of our plays. And every step of the way, Alex met that challenge of being an ESL student whose English, whose language was foreign to him initially, but wanting to be an actor on the English-speaking stage. I found it most interesting when we were doing advanced acting and we were working on Commedia dell'arte, because Commedia dell'arte is a performance style that does not require a recognizable language. All of the actors, no matter where they're from, they speak a form of fake language called Gramalot. And so for Alex, that challenge of trying to speak English was completely removed. He was able to speak Gramalot with all of the other actors on stage, and it allowed him to become so much more expressive physically and vocally.
And he learned from that, and he was able to apply that to some of the other work that he did. So when he was in our plays, he performed in story theater and created these incredibly expressive, over-the-top comic characters. He just recently performed in Fires in the Mirror, where he had to create two different characters based on real human beings. Every step of the way, he continued to meet that challenge. Alex, I want you to know that, first of all, we're going to really miss you from our theater program, and we want to wish you the absolute best in everything that you try to accomplish once you graduate from Columbus State. You were always dedicated in the classroom. You always met all of your assignments with enthusiasm, and you always worked to understand all of these concepts, many of them very new to you, but you continually worked on processing that information and doing the best work that you possibly could. And I know that this is something that you're going to take with you as you move beyond Columbus State. So once again, I just wanted to express how proud I am of you and the work that you've done for the last 2 years and meeting your goals, meeting your dreams, and trying to accomplish your dreams. I don't think that there's anything more important than a human being able to reach for the stars and meet those challenges head on. And you did that extremely well. Congratulations.
Thank you. Thank you, Frank. I would like to say thank you to Frank and all my theater professors that helped me. I would like to say also thank you for my family and my friends for always being there for me. And thank you all. And I would like to say thank you to myself as well for always having a positive attitude and keep on going even when I had challenges. So thank you.
Hello and congratulations to all the graduates of Columbus State Community College. Let's face it, you graduated in a pandemic, and that's extraordinary. I hope you're really proud of yourselves. My name is Bobby Stonerock. I'm an adjunct who teaches, among other courses, legal research and writing and advanced legal research and writing. I love teaching those courses, and my obvious goal is to communicate the material in a way that the students can learn it, but I also really work hard at inspiring and encouraging my students. What often happens, though, is roles get reversed, and it's my students that are encouraging, inspiring me. One of those students is among the virtual graduates. Her name is Jamie Staley. I really enjoyed having Jamie as a student. I first met her in the fall of 2019 and immediately recognized that she was driven, totally necessary to complete a really difficult course. It wasn't until later that I realized how many challenges Jamie was facing outside of our class. So outside of a full schedule at Columbus State, Jamie also worked as a waitress at a local restaurant, picking up shifts where she could. And then, also on top of all of that, she was a single parent to four children from ages 17 to 5. And some of those children have special needs, which required a lot from Jamie. It was extraordinary to watch Jamie learn something in our class, use what she learned to advocate for her children. It just so impressive and so amazing. And not just that, Jamie, when I met her, was healing from an abusive relationship and had so many challenges outside of class that it was just remarkable to me that she could actually complete with high A's both semester the really difficult coursework presented in my classes. Jamie, I am so proud of you. I just can't tell you how impressed I am by your dedication, your perseverance, and most of all, how effective you are at advocating for your children and their right to a decent education. I have no doubt that someday I'm going to click on the Ohio Supreme Court website, click on the little box that lists all the licensed attorneys, and then I'm going to see your name. It's going to be above mine. Staley. You will be a licensed attorney someday, and I will be there to celebrate with you. Congratulations, Jamie.
It's really nice to see Bobby, and there was another professor, Kristen Dickerson. Definitely want to say thanks to them, because even when I struggled or had questions, like, they always took it even outside of school, and, you know, gave me their personal cell phone number and just tried to help where, you know, the help was needed. So that was really nice. I'm really thankful for them. And then my mom for always pushing me, like when I would cry and stuff with the kids' school and felt selfish for finishing my degree. She just was always there to remind me that, you know, I deserve it, they deserve it. It just meant a lot, because I don't think I would have been able to graduate and get my associate's degree if Columbus State had not been so flexible and understanding.
You know, it's a real pleasure to be able to work as a faculty member at Columbus State Community College in the Construction Management Program, Design Construction Trades Department. Run across all types of students, old, young, from a variety of places around the world, variety of interests, variety of backgrounds, but all with the same objective, to learn more and to be able to be productive, contributing, and be able to make a difference. I was fortunate enough to work with one young student, name's Grace, talking with her parents and her initially about her thoughts about Columbus State and what her program of study might look like. And she decided to attack the construction management program. She also has a strong interest in design and other areas, sustainability as well. What a pleasure to have her in class. Her inquisitiveness, her curiosity, her healthy skepticism about things that she was shown and told continues to grow from the very first class I had with her. And she has also been quite an impact on other faculty as well. I think what's most interesting about Grace is the fact that when presented with opportunity to apply for and earn scholarships based on performance and promise, and she attacked it with vigor. Boy, what vigor. She's going to end up graduating from Columbus State 100% on scholarship. She won't be the first, but she's definitely one of the most notable. And in fact, she keeps going. She'll probably end up winning scholarship funding to be able to complete her bachelor's degree at the college of her choosing. What's neat about this is that when I first started working with her, she's still in high school. That's right. And even though we work with students of all ages, all backgrounds, all creeds, they all have one particular interest, and that is, how can I make a difference? What can I do and gain knowledge and skills that will allow me to build upon my talents and gifts and be able to make a difference in the community, the state, the country, and the world? And there's no question, Grace is one of those people. So Grace, whoever you end up working with, at least for your first part of your career, they'll be very fortunate to have you. Congratulations, well done. Such a privilege to work with you. Thank you.
Thank you, Dean, for those kind words. Looking back, when I visited campus with my mom during the summer of my junior year in high school and popped into your office without an appointment, I have to say that it was your enthusiasm and knowledge of the construction management field that inspired me to come to Columbus State as a high school student. I am so grateful for the College Credit Plus program and the caring staff that helped me navigate it. It allowed me to get a head start on my college career during high school. I would like to thank all of my teachers and my fellow students, especially Dean and Dr. Owens, for all the knowledge they shared with me and all the opportunities they opened my eyes to. Columbus State has been a wonderful place to start my learning path, and I look forward to it continuing. Lastly, thanks to my family for all of your love and support. I'm talking to you, Mom. Thank you.
We arrive now at the moment for which our students have worked so hard, the conferring of degrees. We recognize today students earning the degrees Associate of Applied Science, Associate of Technical Studies, Associate of Arts, and Associate of Science. These students have completed all requirements as approved by the college's Board of Trustees and are deemed worthy of distinction as graduates of Columbus State Community College. We recognize our 2020 graduates now, presenting each by academic area. As you review the names of graduates, you'll note that those graduating with honors will be identified as cum laude for those earning between a 3.5 and a 3.79 GPA, magna cum laude for those earning between a 3.8 and 3.94 GPA, and summa cum laude for those graduating with a GPA between 3.95 and 4.0. Our faculty and staff, who are typically among those cheering loudest at each graduation ceremony, have contributed congratulatory messages that will appear throughout our graduate recognition. To the graduates of 2020 and the countless family members and friends whose support was critical to the successes we celebrate today, congratulations. You've accomplished something life-changing, and you've done it under especially difficult circumstances. You're stronger for it, and our community is stronger because of your hard work. We can't wait to see what you do next.
Vanna Brown, congratulations. I knew you could do it. I think you should go celebrate and treat yourself to some Starbucks. Congrats.
Congratulations from the admissions team, 2020 graduates. We are very proud of you and know you will do great things.
Woo! Congratulations, class 2020, woo!
Hi, I'm Terry Stolte, Associate Professor in the Business Programs Department. Congratulations, graduates, in particular, Amber Battle. Please stay in touch. Good luck.
Hi, my name is Amy Popovich, and I am a faculty member in the Business Programs Department, and it is my honor to wear my graduation cap to celebrate the outstanding achievements of all of the Columbus State graduates of 2020. Best of luck in your future endeavors, and a special shout out to those graduates in business programs.
Congratulations, class of 2020. Stay safe.
The great Maya Angelou said, "Nothing will work unless you do." Well, you did it. You put in the work, and we're so proud of you. Congratulations from all of us at Career Services.
Wanted to say congratulations to all of the Columbus State 2020 graduates, and especially to the information systems technology students and art media and design students. Congratulations, way to go. Not only did you finish your college education, but you did so during a global pandemic. That just shows how much amazing perseverance and determination you all have and how dedicated you are to completing your education. So go out there and do amazing things in the world. Congratulations.
Congratulations, class of 2020. We're so proud of you for all the hard work that you put in, and we're all wishing you the very best in the future. Good luck.
Graduates, Y equals MX plus B. We wish that as time continues, your successes continue to increase. Congratulations from the Mathematics Department.
Hi, this is Marcellus Upshaw, Senior Vice President with Bank of America Private Bank. I want to say to the 2020 class, congratulations. This undoubtedly has been a challenging year, and we're looking forward to 2021 and looking forward to the impact that you'll have once you get out there. So again, congratulations to all the graduates and looking forward to a bright new year.
This message is to all of the graduates from the Columbus State Gospel Vocal Ensemble.
Congratulations!
We celebrate you.
Congratulations to the dental hygiene class of 2020.
We're so glad to hear that you're out there working. Just don't forget to keep your instrument sharp and do that wrist rock.
And congratulations on 100% passage rate on all four board exams.
Woo-hoo! Happy to share in the excitement of the graduation day, digital design and graphics. I'm so proud of all of you and your dedication. To me, you're already a great success. Congratulations, class of 2020. Woo!
Congratulations to everyone who graduated from Columbus State during the year 2020. And a special shout out to all the TRIO Student Support Services participants who graduated. Congratulations.
Congratulations from Early Childhood Development and Education. Now go change the world. We are so proud of you, graduates. Congratulations!
Yay! Congratulations!
I'd like to congratulate all of our 2020 graduates and send my best wishes for your next adventure.
I'm here to offer my most sincere congratulations on your graduation. You've demonstrated that you have the knowledge, skills, and abilities to continue to pursue the goals that you've set for yourself. You've graduated in 2020, so you've also demonstrated that you have the resilience to persist and be successful. We wish you all the best as you pursue your goals and look forward to hearing about your achievements. Congratulations on your graduation.
Hello, graduates. We are so excited. We are coming from the Diversity, Equity, and Inclusion Faculty Committee to help you celebrate this tremendous feat that you've accomplished. We're here with your family and your friends to say we are so proud of what you have done, and we look forward to what you're going to do in the future. So from all of us to all of you, we want to say
congratulations!
Congratulations, class of 2020. Good luck.
Congratulations, class of 2020. You did it.
Congratulations, class of 2020 from Student Central.
Congratulations, class of 2020 from Student Central.
Congratulations from Sarah Spalding and her beautiful niece Harper to the 2020 class. We love our Cougars. Go Columbus State. Shout out to the hospitality department. Go Cougs! Go Cougs!
Congratulations to all of our graduates. It hasn't been an easy year, and you all triumphed. I'd like to give a special shout out to all of our graduates in hospitality, nutrition, and sports and exercise studies. Congratulations in the industry. We'll be thankful to have you. Here's to 2021.
Hello to the Columbus State class of 2020. You have graduated and we're so proud of you. You did it! Congratulations!
Congratulations, class of 2020 from Marketing and Communications. We're so proud of everything you've accomplished. Yay! Yay!
Congratulations, graduates. Congratulations for all that you have and will accomplish. And thank you. Thank you for proving to the world, and more importantly to yourself, that even when times become challenging or unfamiliar, you finish what you start. Tomorrow is better because of you.
Congratulations and best wishes. I am Cynthia Bolton, an adjunct instructor in the nursing program, and I have some advice for future nurses. I fear that as future nurses, you'll have bigger challenges than passing your NCLEX. Please take the time and put your PPE on and take care of yourselves. Remember to refresh yourselves. This country needs you. Congratulations and best wishes.
Hi, this is Taylor Slocum with Career Services, wishing you a huge congratulations for all that you achieved this year for your graduation. I also wanted to let you know that your future is looking bright.
Warmest wishes and heartiest congratulations to all the 2020 graduates, and a special shout out to all you future paralegals out there. Congrats again, class of 2020. Way to go, you did it.
Jack, I was so excited when I saw your name on the list of graduates for 2020. Congratulations. I remember you so well from our legal environment and business class. Love getting to know you. You have such great potential, and I know you'll realize it. Congratulations on your new degree. Good luck in your future endeavors.
Graduates of the Social and Human Services Program, Social Work and Human Services Program, I can't wait to see what a difference you're going to make in our helping profession.
We are so proud of you and excited for this next chapter in your life to unfold. And we hope that you don't forget to come back occasionally and say hi.
I know you'll miss me and I'll miss you. And I too hope that we get that you stay in touch with us and let us know how you're all doing. Congrats.
I'm very proud of you. I'm very happy for you. Go out there and do good things.
Hello, Columbus State graduates. I'm Eric Welch, professor in the Sport and Exercise Studies program, and I would like to congratulate all of you all on your graduation during or after this autumn semester. I'd like to also congratulate specifically the Sport and Exercise Studies students, including my son, Tyler Welch, who is graduating with his SES degree in exercise science. You have persevered through very tough times in order to get your degree, and you should be very proud of that and be satisfied with what you've done, but not so satisfied that you don't use your degree to help you and benefit you. Remember to thank those who have helped you along the way, and good luck to all of you as you move forward in the future.
Hello. Just a word to say congratulations to all the graduating Cougars. You did it. This was an amazing semester, and good luck in the future.
Today is your day, 2020 Columbus State graduates. Congratulations on your accomplishment. A special shout out to my baby boy, Tyler Welch, who graduates autumn 2020 from the Sports and Exercise Studies program. I'm so proud of you.
Congratulations, 2020 graduates, especially our communication majors. I hope you're able to take at least a few minutes today to revel in this accomplishment and in making your education a priority. We are here to celebrate with you today and support you in the future with whatever goals await you. You're always part of the Columbus State family.
Class of 2020, congratulations. You've earned this. We're all celebrating you right now. Good job.
Congrats to all of our 2020 graduates. This is a special shout out to the Cougar crew members and the new student programs team, Alex, Amal, and Philip. We are so proud of you and congratulations. You did it. Woo! Congratulations to all of our Columbus State graduates of 2020. We are so proud of you. A special shout out to our graduates of Scholar Network, Women's Connection, Diversity Peer Coordinators, Dream Network, and Man Initiative.
On behalf of everyone in the Career Services Office, we would like to congratulate the 2020 Columbus State graduates. You rose to the challenge, you persevered, and you accomplished your goals. To those of you that we've worked with and those we've yet to work with as alumni, we would just like to say,
you did it! We'll be right back.
Félicitations, monsieur, dame. Auguri, ragazzi. Congrats to the 2020 graduating class. We are so proud of you. You made it. You made it through two really, really, really tough semesters. But you did it. You're there. You're having your diploma handed out to you. You made it. Thank you for letting us be a tour guide on the journey that is your life. We hope we served you well. And maybe you can even put your new learned language skills to the test, either on a future travel or in your professional life. Thank you again and congrats. Yippee!
Congratulations, graduates. You worked so hard to get to this point. All the hours of studying, the deadlines met, the conversations in class. We're so proud of you and excited for you.
Graduates, your friends in Conference and Event Services have a special message for you.
To the class of 2020, congratulations.
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 This year has been challenging.
But you did it, and we're very proud of you.
Now go out and do great things.
Go Cougars!
Congratulations to all of the amazing 2020 graduates of Columbus State. Your hard work has paid off. Great job!
Hi, Columbus State grads. Congratulations. You have persevered and put in so much hard work. You should be very proud of yourself. Best of luck on your continued journey. Way to go.
Hi, my name is Ellen Stadler and I teach in the mathematics department. Since starting at Columbus State in 2010, one of my favorite events has been graduation. Today, I'd like to take a moment to congratulate the class of 2020. You have succeeded during crazy times. In particular, I'd like to congratulate my oldest, Libby Stadler, who is graduating alongside you. Enjoy your day, everyone. You've earned it.
John F. Kennedy says, he sends forth a tiny ripple of hope.
And crossing each other from a million different centers of energy and daring.
Those ripples build a current.
That can sweep down the mightiest wall of oppression and resistance.
Congratulations.
We celebrate our student goodwill ambassadors.
Dalton Darst.
Thea DeRoy.
And Noah Geist. You make Columbus State proud.
Yay!
This is a special shout out to all my Future Scientists of Ohio, LSAMP, and STEM Club scholars. I am so proud of you. If you can graduate college during a global pandemic, imagine all the great things you're going to continue to do. Be sure to keep in touch. Stay on our social media accounts. We want to hear from you. We will ask you to come back for a transfer student panel. I am so proud of you all. I miss you all so much. Please keep in touch. Love you.
Hey, graduates, from everyone in the Biological and Physical Sciences Department, everyone in Anatomy and Physiology, we want to wish you the best graduation ever, and congratulations. You gotta feel proud of yourself. Well done.
2020 graduates, I want to say congratulations. You've made it. For all your future plans, good luck.
Congratulations, class of 2020. A special shout out to all of the students who survived my classes and to all of the STEM Club members. Go out there, thrive, and persevere. Go Cougars!
Congratulations, class of 2020. All of the faculty are so proud of you. I wanted to share with you one of my favorite quotes from Ohio author Toni Morrison. She wrote, "I tell my students, when you get these jobs that you've been so brilliantly trained for, remember that your real job is that if you're free, you need to free somebody else. If you have some power, your job is to empower somebody else." We're so proud of you. We know you'll do great things, and we're rooting for you.
Congratulations! I hope you all know how very proud we are of each and every one of you. We hope that you remember to take advantage of every opportunity that comes your way. And a special shout out to our Future Scientists of Ohio students and STEM Club. You'll always have a special place in my heart, just like all my students at Columbus State. We wish you all the very best.
Congratulations, Columbus State graduating class of 2020. This is a year you will never forget. My name is Skip Weiler. I'm a member of the Columbus State Foundation Board. I'm so proud of each and every one of you, and I know I'm not the only one who is proud. You've worked so hard to get here. Due to your efforts and drive, you've proven how motivated a person you are. I know you'll be successful in whatever you decide to pursue. I'm confident that you will make your community and the world a better place. I could not be happier for you and everyone who has supported you. You are now part of the Columbus State graduation family, and that will always be a part of you. Congratulations, good luck, way to go.
I just wanted to congratulate all those who are graduating. I'm sure the path wasn't always easy, and the world definitely threw you a curveball this semester, but you persevered, You showed your strength. You made it. And we're proud of you. So, congratulations and good luck.
Congratulations, class of 2020. Your many semesters of hard work have paid off. Best wishes in your next and future endeavors.